नमस्ते वनकम सलाम वालेकुम एंड वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल. दिस इज वेंकट अरविंद अगेन. इट्स बिन अ वाइल सिंस आई टॉक टू यू गाइस एंड आई हैव अ लॉट ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन टू शेयर विद यू. फॉर स्टार्टर्स आई लेट यू नो दैट आई एम नॉट इन सिडनी एनी मोर. आई एम नॉट इन सिडनी नोवा स्कोशिया एनी मोर. आई मूव टू टोरंटो. टोरंटो इज अ प्रीटी गुड सिटी. इट्स ब्यूटिफुल एंड मेनली दिस इज द रीजन दैट आई केम टू कैनेडा. यू नो आई वॉन्टेड टू लिव दिस सिटी लाइफ. However, I was living that rural life for like 1.5 years and I got pretty bored of that. I would have moved in early summer itself, but Corona stopped me, the COVID stopped me otherwise. Anyway, finally I'm here now. So I have a bunch of things to share with you. I previously talked in my videos about DLIs. I hope you remember that. DLIs is a designated learning institute. So because of the COVID, there are many changes in the rules and regulations followed by the Canadian government. Now that the corona is all over the world and is spreading chaos everywhere, so the Canadian government took some steps in order to maintain the safety of the people in the country. So what they are doing is they did offer you the semesters online in many universities, but now that everything is a little bit controlled, it's not totally controlled, a little bit controlled. So what they did is they issued a new rule in which your DLI, your designated learning institute, should be an approved DLI. It means it will be having this COVID readiness plan prepared in the college or in your university, and it will be approved by the province, by the province it is in. Even though it is a DLI, that DLI should also go through this COVID readiness plan, and they should have this plan ready in the university or college, and that is when they will be having the opportunity to bring students from any other country. So make sure that if you're getting admission in any college, make sure that your DLI, first of all, it should be a DLI. Second one is your DLI should have a COVID readiness plan. Only then you will be allowed to enter in Canada. So please remember that. And you also have to use ArriveCan app in order to submit your documents and all. It is just an initiative by the Canadian government to make sure that the border security services and the travelers both they both are maintaining distance from themselves, just to avoid these physical papers and all. They have this app called ArriveCan. In that you can basically use that app to communicate through the border security services, by showing your documents and all, etc. And you also have to submit a receipt in which it will be mentioned that you have all your documents, you are approved by a DLI which is approved by the province that it is in, like the COVID readiness plan that I talked about. Number two, these were the two reasons. And the third one is that you should be able to show them, proof that you have the time of 14 days to quarantine yourself, or you have the resources to quarantine yourself for 14 days and then physically attend your classes, or that you can quarantine for 14 days while you can attend your classes online. So that was about the change in rules and regulations. These were for the students that are back in India or any other country, and they are planning to come here to to begin their studies and all. But there is also another issue for students who are already studying here. Many of the students, the DLI they are studying in, they don't have this COVID readiness plan and they are not approved by their province until now. They might be approved a couple of weeks later or a month later. So suppose if they are going back to India now, because the semesters are online and many of the people have gone back to India, suppose their university or their DL, their college or university or the DLI they are studying in, they are not approved, they can leave Canada, but they cannot come back to Canada until they are approved. So this is a very big issue for people who thought that I'll go back and I'll study from home, from India itself, and then when I'm done with the studies, I'll get back and apply for my work permit and all. Those people are in really big trouble. So in case any of your friends are planning to leave Canada, let them know about this, because there are many students who are not aware of this shit. Okay, so this was about the information that I wanted to share with you. There's a lot more, lot of information I will be sharing with you maybe next week. So that's all for today. Thank you, and thank you for listening. Thank you for listening me, and please do comment, subscribe, and like our comment. If you have any questions, you can. Regarding the questions, by the time this video is uploaded, I would have already answered all your emails. So sorry for the delay. I'm going through something. I'm going through a lot, so I didn't. I hope you guys understand. So take care, and khuda hafiz.